Hey everybody, Matt here with Big Red Liquors, and I've got what I think is probably one of the most flavorful, new, and interesting cocktail mixers, elixirs that I have ever seen in our stores. And I'm actually here with Michael Edwards, the inventor of Mee Sorrel Jamaican Tea. And I'm just gonna tell you really quick, this is probably the best thing that I've ever tasted mixed straight up with white rum. So the cocktail that I've done with this, and I'm gonna let Michael speak here in a second, tell us about the flavors in this product, but super easy. Basically, it's an ounce of this, 2 to 3 ounces of the Mee Sorrel, which is this beautiful hibiscus, ginger, cinnamon flavored tea, and then a little bit of simple syrup. You can make it as sweet or as dry as you like. I have a little bit of a sweet tooth, so I like it sweet. But this is just a delicious, tropical, fragrant cocktail. It's got a little bit of bite and dryness to it, but it's just got so much flavor. So, Michael, you're from Bloomington. You're actually producing this product locally. You've been making this product for a long, long time. So tell us a little bit about Jamaican tea, and then tell us a little bit about the flavor profile of Mee Sorrel.
All right, well, thank you, Matt. So, Michael Edwards, and this is a traditional drink I grew up drinking in Jamaica. Came to America to do the educational future outlook for the, future. And in doing so, I managed to carry along making the tea that was, handed down from my mother. So the flavor of it is maybe the hibiscus flower, ginger, cinnamon, clove, rosemary, sweetened with a bit of cane sugar. The amount of sugar is less than orange juice and cranberry, about 10 grams of sugar per serving. And orange juice has about 35 grams, and naked, the flavorful drink that's healthy for you, about 54 grams. So with the ingredients involved, it's all natural. No artificial ingredients, coloring, or flavoring. And the properties is such that it's flavorful. In Jamaica, rum is served with it. So when you go to Jamaica and you go to the bar, you want sorrel, rum is a part of the so-called fabric of the drink. Now, if you go to the restaurant, freshly made, so you can drink it the same day, a week after preparation, mold grows on it. So there's a problem with shelf life. So with the ingredients, the shelf life problem been solved, so you can have it and sit it out for a month at a time, shelf life 1 year, on the shelf.
It won't last a month in your fridge though, because you'll drink most of it. So tell us, what I like about this is it's got the nice kick of spice. It's very floral in its aroma and its flavor profile. It takes the sweetness really well. White rum is, it's kind of like the vodka of the rum world. It really absorbs flavor. It doesn't add a ton of flavor. So if you're just looking for a super easy cocktail, I would suggest white rum at first, but you could use other sort of darker. You could use a Jamaican rum, which usually has like a much stronger, more kind of funky aroma to it. It's got more of those esters, but you don't need it because this is such a fresh flavor additive. And like I said before, if you don't want to do it with rum,
tequila.
It would mix with a lot of different things. But you could also work on mocktails with it, to where you're going to have a lot of flavor if you're working with club soda and a little bit of sugar, and then you've got the extract. So I love it. I love the creativity of it. I love the flavor profile of it. It just tastes like genuine flavor of spice and flour. And it's delicious, and it's new.
Here's the coinage of my slogan for it. My slogan would be fair for me to say, it's not a wine, it's not a juice, but it's an extract. And as an extract, there's not much out there. I once gave a tasting at Lucky's, and it was right before Christmas, and a little young girl was with her parent, and they were curious about what I had. So kids can drink it. Adults can drink it. The seniors can drink
Kids
it.
Kids can drink this, not this.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, they can drink the sorrel without the rum. Mm-hmm. And this little young lady said to me, "Mom, it tastes like Christmas in a bottle." And when she said that was a good coinage with the cinnamon and the clove that's present. It's not overpowering, but yeah, it's there. It's like, under the fabric of the sorrel. But the sorrel carries the tartness, which is where the ascorbic acid for the vitamin C is really right. present. So you have that nutritional part of the sorrel, which is good for coughs and colds.
Yeah.
So an additional other aspect of it is medicinal.
Yeah. Well, it's a great new product. We're really happy to carry it. We're happy that it's local. And best of all, best of anything else, it tastes really good. And it goes great with rum. So, Michael, thank you for joining us, and
yes.
best of luck to you.
Thank Cheers. You very much, Matt. Much obliged. Thank you.